Hey everyone, today in Dino Park development, I'm going to add some functionality to the Triceratops so that it's pretty much like the T-Rex. We're going to let the Triceratops start fights, and we also need to finish the Triceratops running away state. I noticed that the Triceratops runs away and then gets stuck in that state. So as usual, I'm going to start by making a copy of this project. Let's rename it Part 9. Now we can start working. So let's check out the Triceratops. Let's see what we've got here. Get rid of some of these comments. Okay, here's the battle. So the Triceratops is not checking for the battle being active, which is one thing we added last time. There's where we set the running away state. And then here's the state handler. We have a fighting state, but no running away state. So first thing, let's go ahead and do that. Let's add the state handler. That should be nice and easy. Oh, actually, let me just copy one of these. If status is running away, then let's just glide to a random position kind of fast. So wandering is 10 seconds, looking for food is 6. I think running away should be the fastest, so let's try 3 seconds. And we're gonna do that for a little while with a random chance. To transition back to wandering. Yeah, that sounds good. Okay, so let's see if we can copy that from somewhere. Is there no randomness in here? Oh, look at that. Triceratops doesn't have any randomness yet. Okay, well, we'll just make a new operator here. We want to have, if the random number between 1 and 10 is, well, let's do 1 and 4. We don't want to run away for too long. That's equal to 3, and again, this number doesn't matter. It's always going to be a 1 in 4 chance no matter what we put there. So if this random number matches, then we're going to set our state back to wandering. Oh goodness. Oh no. Gotta scroll down carefully. There we go. Set status to wandering. Okay. Let's just double check this. If the status is running away, we're gonna choose a random number. And there's a 1 in 4 chance that we go back to wandering. So we expect on average that it'll take 4 turns for the Triceratops to stop running away and go back to wandering. So to test that, I'm going to update the fighting block right here where we're finding an opponent and choosing whether to fight or run away. And I'm going to say we're never going to accept the challenge. So let's set this to, if the random number from 1 to 2 equals 0, that's never going to happen. So we're always going to run away as soon as we are challenged. Let's see if that does anything. Oh, okay, so 2 T-Rexes started fighting. T-Rexes again. T-Rexes again. Why isn't our Triceratops ever being picked? This Something's suspicious here. When I receive battle.find opponent, let's see. Let's put something in here. We're gonna say let's say what the current value of found opponent is. 0. Oh, but we're too far away. Okay. We were too far away. Let's try it again, because I know they were close together one time. 0, 0. Zero. Okay, let's move this guy right there and now start. There we go. Running away. So let's keep an eye on that. And in roughly 4 turns, the Triceratops should transition back to wandering. It's been at least 4 turns, so what is going on? Let's take a look here at our state machine. Oh, I think we did transition back. Yeah, running. Okay, so that's just a stray say command. So this say command right here stays active the whole time. Let's get rid of that, because that was very confusing. And if we want to debug status, let's just do this. Let's just say our status on every turn. Like that. And now we can really quickly see wandering. There, that's perfect. So that's working. And I guess we can get rid of this one too, because the status will change to fighting. We'll be able to see that. Okay, let's add this if statement, the if battle active equals 0. And that's to prevent any possibility of 2 pairs of dinos starting to fight at once. And the reason that doesn't work is because we're using this single pair of global variables, battle.attackerX and battle.attackerY. Since we have this single pair of global variables telling us where the attacker is, that gets overwritten. When we look for a fight, we have to set those variables so that all the other dinos know how far away they are. Right? So if you accept the challenge, you set defender, but when you issue the challenge, you set attacker. And that was getting overwritten. So we could switch that into being some kind of list so that more than one fight could happen at a time. But let's keep it simple for now. One fight at a time, which really is enough in an enclosure. A single enclosure, one fight is enough. So we just need to add that to our find opponent handler. This, oh, we can get rid of that say because we figured out what was going on. We were just too far away. If equals, that's going to be a 0, and we need to find our battle.active variable. So there we go. And we can restore this to being 50-50. Great. Triceratops behavior is updated. Now, you know, I said we were going to make Triceratops pick fights, but I actually wanted to work on something else, and that is the ability for the player to add dinosaurs. So we're going to get started with the incubation part of the game. Let's add a button. And we're going to call it, hatchery. How about that? Oh, here's a question. Should there be a hatchery in the enclosure, in the enclosure screen? Should you be able to add dinos directly there, or do we need a different interface, like an island map? You know, if you could see a map of the whole island, then you have all your different buildings, and you could go to the hatchery. That's probably a better idea, but for now, I just want to get it working. Whoa. Oh man. I clicked the button and it worked. Because it's a clone of the info button. Hatchery button. First of all, let's call it a hatchery button, just to be consistent. And let's make it visible. Oh gosh, this is tough. When this sprite clicked, we don't want to show info. Oh boy. Let's hide the info. Now we can drag this down. Let's go back to the map. It's funny how you can kind of use your game while you're actually trying to edit your game, because you click something in here and it actually executes the code. How do we line this up? Y is minus 142. No, I didn't mean to really click it. Map 142. Okay, that's good. So it's at least lined up vertically. And now let's change the text on it. We're gonna call it. Oh, how do I edit this? Uh-oh, there we go. Hatchery. Try to center that. Is that centered? That looks about right. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Now, we're going to copy this info screen and call this hatchery. Now, what is the hatchery going to do? Let's modify. We can get rid. Oh, would it be cool to. No. We don't want to show that kind of info. Let's add a costume. And okay, you have to be able to choose a dino to incubate. Okay, we need to have a list of dinos that are incubating and how long it's going to be. Oh man, that's complicated. That's too much to do for today. So let's do this instead. We've got our hatchery thing, which is going to just be kind of a backdrop. The info screen used to be a backdrop, and I changed it to a sprite so that we could animate it and make it look cooler. And then I never actually animated it, so maybe it's completely pointless. But let's just go with it. We're gonna just treat this like a backdrop. How did I f Oh, you have to convert it to a bitmap to fill it, I think. So convert to bitmap, then go to fill. Let's choose a nice color. How about a nice light green for the hatchery? I kind of like that. There, filled. Now convert to vector. And that should be okay. Let's give it a little title up here. We're going to say hatchery, and that we want that to be black again. Make it bigger. There we go. This is the hatchery. Now, I think eventually, like I said, we're going to have like a list of things here. How can we do that? I could go ahead and put some labels there. We don't have to make it actually work. How about pod one? And then pod two, pod three, pod four. Like that. And then the values will just go over here. Those are going to be other sprites to show you what's being incubated, how far along it is, maybe an ETA for how long it's going to be. And then we need to have a way of selecting a dino. So, oh yeah, okay. So we need to have a little button there. If there's something already in that pod, then we show the information. But if the pod is empty, we show a button that says incubate. And then that's going to take us to a dino selection screen. Yeah, that sounds good. So we have a hatchery button. Now we need an incubate button. That's almost centered already. And I think right around there. Oh, but this button might be too big. Yeah. Okay, yeah, we don't want such a big button here. Let's make this. Oh, wait, no, I can just shrink it over here. Yeah, that's a nice thing about Scratch. We can just change the size right here. Okay, so this is going to be called incubate button. And let's make the size 50%. Okay, that looks good. This is going to have clones, I guess. But for now, again, we're keeping this simple. The thing I'm trying to do today is just be able to clone dinos. So, incubate button. And then we're going to need another screen. So we're going to copy the hatchery screen, duplicate that, and call this incubation selection. Wait, incubation selection or incubate selection? Or should we just call it dino list? No, that sounds like. Dino list sounds like the list of your current dinos, which would be a nice screen to have, I think. Kind of like the info screen, but showing all dinos at once. That's a good idea. But let's call this incubation list. Sure. Okay, and let's go into edit it. I think keeping the green background is fine because it's part of the hatchery. Yeah, that actually makes sense. Let's just change the title. Incubation list. Or no. This should be a direction to the user. So choose a dino. And let's slide this over. And then we don't want this. Oh, how do I delete this? Oh yeah, gotta click that first, I think. Delete that. Choose a dino, and then we could just put pictures here that you click or buttons. I think we probably need a list of. Hold on. Yeah. We need both. For now, I'm just going to use text, T-Rex, or should we be Tyrannosaurus Rex? Yeah, that looks good. Tyrannosaurus Rex. Well, that's kind of long, but yep, that's just how it is. Tyrannosaurus Rex, Triceratops. And then over here, we're going to have a button to say incubate. And another button later that says modify. Because one of the cool things about the game is you can modify the genome to change how a dino looks, but maybe even more importantly, to change characteristics like their attack power, defense power, lifespan, resistance to diseases, all kinds of stuff. There's a bunch of options. And that's one of the fun things about this type of game is optimizing your build. For now, we only have these two dinos. That's going to have to become a dynamic list. And I don't know how to do dynamic text yet. That's something we'll have to figure out when we get there. But not today. Not today. So this is called the incubation list. We're going to need some buttons. Incubate button. Oh, can we just. We could reuse that, but that's a little confusing. So even though it's still going to say incubate, this is going to be called the select incubation select button. And then we're going to have another one called the incubation modify button. And that one is just going to say modify. Oh, look at that. That's how we can center it. Why wasn't that little thing showing up on my other buttons when I was trying to center things? Let's see if it works again. So here, incubate is fine. See, the center point isn't showing up on this one. Why is that happening? That's bizarre. It's showing the center point of the sprite, but not of the text. Whereas here, I was able to see that. Oh, it's blue. Look at that. This one just happens to be on the black part of the D, so I can line it up. But here, it must be in the blue area. Yep, there, I lined it up. It snapped into position. I don't know if you could see that in the video, but it did snap into position. So incubation button, we're gonna say is, yep, nice and small. Let's show this screen and then we can line these up. Oh, this is confusing because I don't know which button is which. Wait a sec, wait. Let's line this up first. So we've got the hatchery and we want that to be at 0, 0. Like that, perfect. And that incubation button is called the incubate button. Oh boy, this is confusing. But let's hide that one. Let's hide that one. And now we can line this one up. And again, this is kind of like the future plan. It's going to show you some information here, but we're not doing that today, if that makes sense. Now we've got our incubation dino list. Let's center that. And I guess we have to hide that. It must be on top of the other. There we go, choose a dino. And now our incubate button, let's hide that so we know we're selecting the right one. So we want to show this and show this. So for now, you can only do the T-Rex, I guess. Incubate and modify. See how that's going to look? And then later we'll have another button for Triceratops, and it's going to be a dynamic list of all the dinos you have available based on the fossil expeditions you've made. Let's line these up vertically. So that is a Y coordinate of 68, and this one is 69. Let's make them both 69. I feel like it should be a little higher. Like that. There we go. Nicely lined up. Great. So this was a lot of extra work for screens that don't even work, but that's okay. That is okay. Now let's make the buttons actually do something. Here's the hatchery button. Go to the code. Instead of broadcast show info, we're going to say show hatchery. Oh, actually, with our namespace idea, let's call it hatchery.show. We want to namespace all of the things related to the hatchery together so that they're more organized. Like in the dropdown, you'll see all the hatchery messages next to each other. And for this one, we're definitely going to have multiple because we've got buttons on this page that are also going to broadcast hatchery messages. So broadcast this button, the hatchery button, is going to show up on the map and it's going to hide here and it's going to hide, oh, you know, we're going to have to add this to every single sprite. because we want the dinosaurs to be hidden on this page. That makes me think, rather than a separate message for each one, how about if we have a show screen message and then a global variable that says which screen we're showing? That is going to make this a lot easier. So let's see, how can we do that? When I receive, let's just make a new message, show screen. And then we need to make a new variable, screen dot name, I guess. So screen is our namespace, and that means this message should have been screen.show. Let's try to keep it consistent, and hopefully, if no one's using a message, I hope Scratch will automatically delete it. It doesn't look like it because it's still showing up there, but we'll see. When I receive screen.show, then we need an if statement or an if else. If, so which button are we on? We're on the Hatchery button. So the only screen that we want to show is the map screen. So see, I took it away from show map. We can get rid of that. And get rid of that. We need an operator equals. We're gonna only show ourselves if we are showing the map screen. So screen.name, there it is. We don't want that to be visible. Screen.name, if screen.name equals map, then show else hide. That is great. Let's copy this. And I'm still not 100% sure how to do this efficiently. Put it there and there and there and there, yep. And there and there. 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 We're not on the incubate button, are we? I don't know what happens if you drag it to itself. Let's stop for a second and update what we have. So let's go to the triceratops. Here's our new block. Now, when I receive show info, we want to do this stuff. So if screen name is info, oh no, sorry. If screen name is map, we want to show. And oh, look at this. We do have some actions to take for the info screen. So we need another if statement, or rather an if else. So here we have like that. Oh man, gotta move this first. Actually, I could have left it like that. So if we're not on the map, we definitely want to hide. But furthermore, if we are on the info screen, if we're going to the info screen, we need to see if we're selected and then update globals. Yeah, let's do that. Can't I just copy something here? Okay, let's copy this. Even though this seems really strange, it is actually easier than going through all the different sections and finding the operator and the variable and all of that. So if we're going to the info screen and we are selected, oops, I copied the wrong one. Okay, if we are selected, we want to update globals, set the info type, which I don't think we're actually using, and then broadcast info update type. Oh yeah, we are using that, I think. We're using that to show the right picture on the info screen. Okay, so that is a little more complicated, but it takes away that block and this one. We don't need that. And I thought that, oh yeah, and we don't have to add the one about the hatchery. Yeah, so that's good. I think that's simpler. Now let's copy that for the T-Rex. And I'm gonna try this. I'm just gonna drag it right over there because I think, yep, that copied it without me having to click duplicate first. Cool. Learning this scratch thing. Let's go to our T-Rex, and there's our new block. And there's the old one I copied. Get rid of that. So this looks good, but info type should be T-Rex, of course. And then we can clean up. We don't need, what don't we need? We don't need show info handler because that's part of show screen. And we don't need show map handler. Okay, now the info button is simpler. We're not doing any complicated logic. It's just if we're on the map, show, otherwise hide. Oh, and I can get rid of the old handler. So we can get rid of show map. We can get rid of show info, and we don't need to add a show hatchery or any of that stuff. Herbivore feeder, same thing. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. It is handled right here. Map button. The map needs to be shown on the info screen, otherwise, it's hidden. Oh, and I've got to go to front layer. That's probably good to have. We do want those kind of UI elements to be in the front. That is good. Okay, rename button. That we want to only be visible on the info screen. And let's, yep, there's the show layer or go to front layer. Get rid of that handler. Oh, and this, and get rid of that handler. And we're left with these. Info screen. Ah, yeah, this is also showing the variables, isn't it? And that's fine. So if screen name is info, we do that. And otherwise, yeah, let's hide all this stuff too. We only need one hide. There. So I think this is simplifying things, especially as we're adding new screens, because we don't need to keep adding completely new blocks to all of our sprites. And look at this, our list of sprites is growing and growing. Okay, hatchery button, that appears on the map. That is correct. Let's add that go to front. That was a good idea to put it on all the buttons. Go to front layer. Hatchery screen. We only want to show if we are on the, oops, hatchery screen. And get rid of that. Get rid of that because we're not showing any variables yet. And get rid of that. That was just copied from the info screen. Incubation button. When this sprite clicked, we're going to broadcast screen.show and set screen.name to what's it called? Incubation dino list? Is that what it was? Let's see, incubation list. Okay, let's call it incubation list. Like that. And then we don't want that. We don't want that. We are going to copy this button. Oh, wait, no, I don't need to duplicate. I just drag it over there. And we want to show if the screen is hatchery. Now let's copy this one to that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. The only thing we want this to do is show if the screen is incubation list, right? And here, oops, need to copy that. Copy that. And this is the same. This button only gets shown if the screen is incubation list. And, oh yeah, we are gonna need, well, we're gonna need something. I don't know what yet, but definitely not show info. We don't need show map. We don't need show info. Copy this. Okay, let's do a quick test and make sure that our buttons are working. And here's a problem. Here is a problem. When the game starts, I used to broadcast show map. We want to broadcast screen.show, and we want to set the screen. Dot name to map. Let's try that again. Oh, look at that. First test passed. It did show the map. So now if we select a dino and choose info, nothing's happening. Okay, maybe we didn't. Yep, it's still broadcasting show info. Look at that. We want to set our variable to map. Oops, not battle active. Screen.name. And then we want to broadcast show screen.show. Now let's try it. Ready? Info. We want to show the info screen, not the map screen. Info. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. And now the map button is not working. And I think we know why. Apparently I deleted the click handler entirely on this one. Nope, there it is, but it's broadcasting show map. So let's go to our button that we just did and duplicate that for the map button. Except we want to set the screen back to map. Now if we click it, it goes back to the map. Very good. Let's see, the rename button is broadcasting save name. That's fine. That's not showing or hiding anything. The info button, so we are going to need to update that, right? Or am I crazy? Oh, no, that's not the info button. That's the info screen. That is fine. Hatchery button. Yep, let's copy this. This has to go over to here. We're going to set the screen name to Hatchery. And we're showing the Hatchery. Beautiful. And we're showing that incubate button, but not the modify button. What? Yeah, that's wrong. That should be if the screen is the hatchery, right? Or am I crazy? Incubation list. That's to choose a dino. Oh yeah, I'm wrong. That is supposed to be only on the incubation list. The incubate button should be on the hatchery, and it is. Yeah, oh yep, it's working perfectly. Look at that. And then I click that and we go to choose a dino. That's not working because these buttons should have shown up. If screen name, show and go to front layer. Ah, this go to front layer should probably be go to back layer. Let's try again. So we're going to look at the hatchery. We're going to click incubate. And there. Now the screen went to the back layer and the two buttons went to the front layer. So they're on top of the screen and they work. And I can click incubate or modify. Eventually we'll need a cancel button, like down here or something, to say, never mind, I changed my mind. But, oh goodness, all this work to get to this point. So the incubation button, when this sprite is clicked, we are going to just broadcast a new message called, didn't I create a hatchery namespace already? Maybe not. But let's call it hatchery.incubate. No, let's call it at, because that is eventually what it's going to be. For now, we're skipping the incubation phase and we're going directly to hatching, because I just want to get a dino cloned. You know what I mean? Hatchery.hatch. And we need to have a hatch type variable to say what dino needs to hatch. Make a variable, hatchery.hatch type. This is going to be the type of dino that's hatched. So for this button, it's T-Rex. If the button down here is clicked, it's going to have to get that value from a list eventually, and it'll be Triceratops. So we need to set that value. Hatchery.hatch type to T-Rex. Now, the T-Rex needs a handler. When I receive hatchery.hatch, if the type is T-Rex, then that means us. That means we are the ones who need to hatch. T-Rex. And we're looking at the hatch type. Then we are going to, for now, we're just going to create a clone like that. Oh, wait a second. We don't want all, let's see what happens, but I know what's going to happen. All of the clones are going to hatch. But let's do this. So after you broadcast hatchery, the next thing we're going to do is switch to the map. So we're going to set the screen to map so we can see the effect here, and we're going to broadcast screen.show. All right, so when I click this, nothing happened. Broadcast hatchery.hatch, hatchery.hatch type. Let's look at the T-Rex one more time. When I receive, oh, I didn't change this. I clicked the wrong one. When I receive hatchery dot, what a letdown. Okay, let's try that again. Go to the hatchery. We're gonna incubate in pod one. We're gonna choose the T-Rex. Still nothing? Still nothing? Oh, there they are. Okay, do you see what happened there? Okay, this is, let me explain. This is what happened. When we clicked that button, we hatched the dinosaurs, and then we showed the screen, but we used broadcast, not broadcast and wait. It's that same old problem. This script keeps going while the other script is paused. We want to let the dinos have time to hatch, because otherwise we went ahead and sent this message as well, and we showed the screen before the clones were hatched, and so they hatched hidden, because when the hatch happens, these dinos are hidden. We're showing the button, all the clones are hidden. That means that when we create the clone, it's also hidden. Then we send this message, but the clones didn't get it because they weren't created yet. It's a little complicated, and I'm not even 100% sure it's right. Oop, look at that, almost Almost messed that up. Now let's try it, and we're gonna get a bunch of T-Rexes. Hatchery, incubate, incubate. Oh, I can't even tell. Let's just start over. We've got three T-Rexes. Let's go to the hatchery, incubate, incubate. And yep, I see extra T-Rexes. It's hard to tell. Oh, look at that. We cloned the fighting T-Rexes, and so the clones are also fighting. Oh my goodness. We need some more initialization here. When I start as a clone. Oh, well, we've got two problems to fix. First of all, the original dino never is shown, I believe. Is that right? Where do we create clone of myself? Okay, so the original dino is shown. Yeah. Well, we don't want that. I think what I was thinking is let's keep the original dino as kind of the template. But this video is already getting too long. We made a lot of progress. We made our hatchery buttons work. And you can click the incubate button and it will spawn a bunch of T-Rexes. So I think that's enough for today. We're gonna keep working through these issues in the next video. Thanks for stopping by. Bye.